What is truth? This is the question that Pilate had asked Jesus when he said, I have come into this world to testify of the truth. Pilate had replied, what is truth? The truth evidently of which Jesus testifies is not the philosophical truth, namely the reality which surrounds us when we already understand this and that our thought is adequate for this reality. We are in the truth around a judgment conformed to reality. No, the truth witnessed by Jesus is much deeper. It concerns a specific subject. Jesus has not come to reveal biology nor physics at all. The only subject for which he came is to reveal salvation of mankind. The question of the truth concerning salvation, and he will reveal that this truth of salvation, Jesus, is a person. It is the person of the Father, of whom he himself is the eternal Son. It is very important to understand this, because if someone desires to understand why we are on earth, why all of this, and he or she does not understand the Trinity, if his Catholic theology does not understand that, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, then the person lacks the basic principle of intelligibility of it all, which unexplained to all our life on earth. So any Christian theology which relativizes the question of the Trinity by making it just one chapter among others, which is not central, cannot understand anything, and I will explain why. We see incomprehensible things in our world. For example, we are created with a mortal body and a spirit that will not deserve to die. And furthermore, we are created on earth. It is a terrible fate. Animals are happier than we are. They don't know that one day they are going to die. How can one explain this simple question, therefore? Only a higher wisdom can explain this, namely the one who designated this project, God himself. So there are many explanations. We say God is love. Therefore, if God is love, why did he create us? As we are in misfortune, it's incorrect to say so, nor does it make sense, nor can we say we are created with love by making us free, which puts us on earth so that we may choose. That's not true either. Only a few are free. We remain subjects to our own impulse. For example, we are not masters that may prevent a criminal from killing us when he is committed to do so, and then that we haven't chosen to die either. So for all these reasons, which we find ourselves incapable of explaining all the incurrence suffering, in reality, only the crucified Christ, who has revealed who the Father is and why creation is all present. This is what Jesus came to testify to. I have come to testify of the truth. What is truth? Answer, the Father loves the Son very much, and the Son loves the Father, and their love is called the Holy Spirit. This is the mutual and reciprocal love. The Father loves the Son, and the Son is none other than his own perfect knowledge of himself, and therefore himself before himself, since knowledge is identical to himself. Result, the Father is very being consists in saying this is a substancing relationship. I am only through you, my Son, only through you. You are there, my Son, you are greater, exalt. I will exalt you everywhere. And the Son says to the Father, I am only by you. A son is only because he has a father, and therefore you are greater than me. From everything you proceed, I will exalt you, I will exalt you. It means that the three persons of the Holy Trinity, the Holy Spirit, bidirectional love, so to each of the other persons, you alone count. Their being is a being not only of love, the Holy Spirit, but of humility, of kenosis, of greatness of the other, not of oneself. God died to himself by giving life to the other person of the Trinity. This is so immense to understand that if we are created now free of charge by this God to see him face to face, we understand very well that we must acquire a heart which resembles to the Holy Trinity, at least a little, with humility. Otherwise, we could not bear the beatific vision. Certainly, he created us out of love. And if it were enough to love God, we will already be with him. In addition, we must have a heart adapted to this mystery springing from eternity, from infinity, the kenosis of God, and therefore we must be dead to ourselves. We must learn, endeavor, to have a small, poor, humble heart. No need to attempt to acquire it by ourselves. We will not succeed in doing so, and therefore we are put upon earth for a certain time, in order for us to go through trials, silence, death, and in the end, finally, through suffering, trial. For those who desire God shall obtain a humble heart or soul. He will create the adapted heart, and we will see God face to face. This is the truth of which Jesus came to testify.